I got hit some. I ain't hit one yet, neither. Here we go. There we go.
So, how was your path after graduation?
So I graduated from University of Delaware in 2013. I went straight to Wilmington University, and I got my master's. I actually wanted to be a teacher first. I got my master's in secondary education to be a math teacher.
Have you always wanted to be a teacher?
I always wanted a job where I'm around people. Yeah. I just love people.
What do you like being about? Being a cop.
About being a cop?
About it,
yeah. Let me tell you, I can go on 5 different complaints.
Yeah.
One complaint, I could be a mentor. The next complaint, I could be getting guns and drugs. The next complaint, I can be a counselor for a marriage couple or whatever. So I just love the dynamic of the job. And it always, like every day it challenges you every day to think on your toes, to think different. So each complaint, each day is the unknown. You don't know what you're going into. So I love that aspect about the job. And like I could go up to somebody, man, they can feel hopeless. They can, the world can be, you know, darkness. So here you come, you're meeting people at their lowest point and you have the opportunity to give them hope, to be their light in their world full of darkness. So I just love that aspect. I'm telling you, so. What about you? Why you want to be a cop?
Around the same reason. Mm-hmm. I mean, I always like to help people.
People, do you love people? You gotta love people to do this job.
Oh, yeah.
And you have to conduct yourself in a manner that their reaction and how they treat you should never dictate how you treat them.
Yeah, exactly.
Because if you're meeting somebody at the lowest point in their life, you have to be an understanding person. In the back of your mind, you always expect the worst because you're aware. You can always expect the worst and still be ready and calm at the same time. I could be ready and calm.
That gotta be hard.
Yes, at the same time. You know,
balance all those emotions.
Yes, exactly. And you should know, playing football, it's always like
game of emotions.
Yes, exactly. So.
I say the biggest thing is discipline.
Discipline. Discipline. That was the word I was looking for.
Yep.
Discipline, because when you're in academy, you got to be up at a certain time.
Yep, like
you're only allowed to eat certain foods.
Yep.
You got to have your clothes ready the day before. Uh-huh. And everything is about time.
Time, man.
Same thing with football. Even the physical aspect, too. When that defensive lineman is going at you, you got to be in attack mode. You got to let them know, look, you're not getting my quarterback, whether you like it or not. And it's the same way on the street. So, did you always want to be a police officer?
I wanted to be a doctor.
A doctor?
You know, you're a servant to
right.
the community.
Right.
You know, like, and you're able to help people.
Right.
And then, like you said, like the dark times, the good times.
Right. And that kind of goes in to the reason why I became a police officer. I always told myself, if there's a problem with something, first off, you have to humble yourself to it. So if I thought there was a problem between the community and policing, first, I have to humble myself. I took my opinion out. I took my feelings out of everything.
That's a big thing for you, keeping your opinion out of it?
Yes, keeping your opinion out of it.
Yeah.
So I humbled myself, and then I educated myself. I call that phase going through the academy, learning the other side.
It's a good idea for a cop who grew up in that community to be a police officer in that community. Do you think that helps out?
Yes, yes. It definitely helps out a lot.
In your
and nowadays, we live in a society now where ignorance is a choice.
Oh yeah.
There is so, even if you didn't grow up in that community, there are so many books, there are so many resources out there for us to learn that community. It takes nothing to take 30 minutes out of my day, or let's just say an hour out of my week. I'm gonna find an hour out of my week to get out my car, engage with the community, and understand them, and know them. And that's so important. So I humble myself, educated myself on both sides, say, okay, I get what you mean over here, and I get what you mean over here. So then I put myself in position.
Equalizer.
Yes, to make that change. If I'm supposed to be an example to my wife and to my unborn daughter, you know what I mean? I'm supposed to be, I want my daughter to look at me and say, oh, dad was a person that didn't complain. Dad was a person that looked at a situation, he analyzed it, he assessed it. In all aspects, and he went out and he did something about it.
How was that video? What did that video mean to you?
Oh, that video was everything.
Yeah.
Because.
Did you expect it?
No, I didn't expect it. It is so important that you make it an everyday habit. You make it who you are. In uniform, outside of uniform, you want to get the same Josh across the board.
You're not acting because you're on.
Yeah, I'm not exactly. So that's why I didn't expect it.
Let me say this is an excellent young man, wonderful king, bright future. Let me just say that. But aside from that, I hate when you beat somebody And then they point out their names.
No, but I told you to play again, though.
But I played you.
You got me, right? You beat me. All right, okay. But if you want to play again, it's up to the
next. Lead by example.
You can't tell people to do things if you're not willing to do it yourself.
Exactly. Lead by example and be pure-hearted. But don't use foul and abusive language. Let your words be encouraging and helpful to those who hear them.
Well, I come from a pretty decent-sized town where families knew each other. And
yeah.
Everyone was tight-knit. And if you had a problem like this, the police was always there to help.
Right.
You know, instead of it being an inconvenience toward them. So that's how I've always seen policing on my end.
Right. And I'm around a lot of officers that do a lot of community work that are good, great, 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 great officers. Whatever. Not just me. It's not just me. It's a bunch of us that do it. A bunch of us. There we go.